Watch this video to learn about how you can use the SwiftUI environment to pass custom values down the view hierarchy. Hey, this is Flo, and in this video we will discuss the SwiftUI environment. I have already prepared an empty startup project here, and what we will do is we will pass a color through the SwiftUI environment and then use it in a subview, without actually passing it explicitly through the view constructor. There are about 4 steps that we need to do, so this is rather quick, so let's jump right into it. First of all, we need to create an environment key with a default value of what we want to pass through. So let's create a struct, and let me also zoom in a bit. Let's call this main color key and conform to the environment key protocol. To conform to the protocol, we need to implement a static var default value with the type that we want to pass down. So in our case, we want to pass down a color, and the default value should be red. Now, this is where you need to explicitly state the type that you want to pass. So for example, if you want to pass down some text, then this needs to be a string. Okay, so I think you get how the environment key works. Next up, we need to register this environment key in the environment values, which is basically what's accessed through the @environment property wrapper. So for that, we need to create an extension on environment values. Here we have to create a computed variable, and we will call it the main color, which is of type color. And then we need to explicitly state a getter and a setter. So the getter is very easy. Let's just say self, and then with this subscript, we need to access the main color key dot self. This is where we get the value from. And then if we want to set a new value, we do basically the same. So we say self, and then through the subscript of our main color key dot self, and we can set that to the new value, which is a parameter that the setter gets, which you do not have to explicitly capture, by the way. Okay, so step one was the environment key. Step two was the environment values. And now we can have an optional step here that just makes our life a little bit easier. So we can just create an extension on view, so we can easily set our main color without having to do dot environment backslash dot main color and so on and so on. We can just have a convenience function here basically. So let's call this main color, and it takes in a color of type color, and it returns some view, as this is basically a view modifier. And then this internally just calls environment with a key pass to our main color, basically the environment value that we just specified here in line 15. And then we pass in the color that we got as an argument, like this. Okay, and now we can already use this inside of our view. So for that, let's create a second view here. Let's call it second view, which conforms to the protocol view. Of course, it also has a body. And in here, we will just have, let's say, a text saying second view with a foreground color. And now this foreground color is basically the main color that we want to grab from the environment. So to grab it, as always, just say @environment backslash dot main color, our environment value that we specified, var main color. And now we can pass that into our second view's foreground color. Now let's use the second view. So in our content view, let's have our second view. And now we can use our convenience function that we had here. So we can say dot main color, and let's pass in color.blue. Okay, now let's run the preview and have a look at how all of this works together. Okay, so now the preview is running, and you can see the text second view has a foreground color of blue, which is exactly what we specified as our main color here. And then it got passed into the environment through this extension function that we wrote, which internally sets the environment value main color through the environment key that we created. Now let's also wrap this in a VStack, and below let's not set the main color, and then you will see where our default value here comes into play, because the second view now has a red foreground color, because that's the default value, which is used because we didn't provide any main color specifically. So to wrap things up, step one, create an environment key. Step two, specify a default value for that environment key. Step three, make the key accessible through the environment values. Now there's the optional step 3.5, I'd say, where you create an extension on view to have that convenience function. Of course, instead of using this main color function, you can always just directly use the .environment function like this. It's exactly the same. I think it just looks a little bit nicer on the eye if you have this convenience function. And this is also how, for example, fonts and foreground colors and tint colors get passed through the SwiftUI hierarchy internally. So I think this is just a nicer API. And then the last step, of course, is reading the value back from the environment using the @EnvironmentProperty wrapper. If you enjoyed this video and found the tip helpful, please make sure to like the video, leave a comment with other ideas or how you plan to use this tip, and then also subscribe to the channel if you want to learn more about Swift and SwiftUI. That's it, and I will see you next time. Bye.